I'm Karen Califat. I'm the priest in charge here at St. Luke's in the Meadow. This is one of the four saints for which this operation is named. My colleagues from St. Alban's Arlington, Kevin Johnson, Father Scott McComas from St. Martin's in the Field in Keller, and Father Bob Gross from St. Stephen's in Hurst welcome you all to this great event. We and our parishioners actually are the ones who made this happen. We're honored by your presence here and by your support. This year, our bishop has talked a lot about being on fire with the Spirit. 2 years ago, a then newly ordained deacon named Tony Hyatt had the spark of an idea for feeding the hungry in this area. Tony?
Hey, Tony.
We thank you. The flame that you lit has led us to this great event today. Tony is now a priest and serving in the Episcopal Church in Wise County. Also want to welcome the Bishop of the Episcopal Diocese of Fort Worth, Scott Mayer, our assisting bishops Rayford High and Sam Holsey. We welcome Fort Worth's Mayor, Betsy Price, Tarrant Area Food Bank Director, Bo Soderberg, and members of his team, Jeanette Scott and Barbara Ewan. We also welcome Allison Butts of Eastside Ministries, Ricky Cotto with Fort Worth's Blue Zone Group, Robert Dowdy, our neighborhood police liaison, and other city officials who are here for this event. And of course, we welcome all of you who have volunteered and contributed to this project in so very many ways. Your presence and your work is vital to the efforts to care for those who have great needs in our community. There is one person here today who took the flame that Tony lit and nurtured and cared for it for countless hours until it has grown into this beacon of hope for our sisters and brothers living with hunger. It is truly an honor for me to introduce to you Patty Callahan. Patty is the president of the board of 4Saints Episcopal Food Pantry. She's highly involved here at St. Luke's in the Meadow. She will now give you a brief history and the vision of this project.
As you just heard, 4Saints Episcopal Food Pantry began in late 2014 as the dream of the Reverend Tony Hyatt. First St. Luke's, then the three other congregations joined in the effort to make that dream a reality, a God-guided endeavor from the very beginning. After an intense 2 years of research, visiting existing food pantries, grant writing, praying, repairs to the exterior of this once underutilized building, interior modifications to house the pantry, upgrading the electrical to service to handle food storage equipment, adding air conditioning, praying for volunteers to operate the pantry, and welcoming them as the board of directors approved their positions and each joined the team. 4Saints Episcopal Food Pantry is now an agent of Tarrant Area Food Bank. The board of directors is made up of at least two members from each parish and one affiliate board member, Annabelle Sauer, Girl Scout Troop 3012, Fort Worth. Board members are the Reverend Karen Califat, Alan Phillips, Mitch Herod, the Reverend Kevin Johnson, the Reverend Henry Penner, Joy Malmgren, Elizabeth McPherson, Diane Snow, Rick Kern, and I. Each member is committed to the common goal, hunger relief in East Fort Worth. The pantry staff team, all volunteers, has met the required training to operate a pantry and includes the director, Judith Cariker, food coordinator George Post, interview coordinator Elizabeth McPherson, and volunteer coordinator Don Mayer. 4Saints serves three zip codes around St. Luke's, 76103, 76112, and 76120. This area, which includes nearby Meadowbrook Elementary across Meadowbrook Drive and Meadowbrook Middle School just behind our parking lot. And this area qualifies as a food desert. This means people have to travel a mile or more to acquire fresh fruit, vegetables, and other healthful whole foods at grocery stores, farmers markets, or any other healthy food providers. Another measure of food insecurity is that the majority of students at these two schools are in free meals. During the 2 years making this pantry a reality, including a site visit 2 years ago by Jeanette Scott of the food bank,
right there.
She saw it before anything was done, really before a step was taken. The Tarrant Area Food Bank has offered information and advice about the requirements of operating a food pantry and how to efficiently offer food to our hungry neighbors. We are proud to be a member of the Hunger Relief Network of Tarrant Area Food Bank. And now I invite Bo Soderberg, the Executive Director of Tarrant Area Food Bank, to share his thoughts on this occasion.
Thank you. There is, in my mind, no higher praise for an effort than to have Jeanette and Barb come and talk to me and say, Bo, you've got to come with us to look at 4Saints Pantry. We have 270 some odd partner agencies, and to my mind, not one of them has been put together with such deliberation, such selflessness in choosing to put it where there really was a need as opposed to next door to where I am. I wish we could use you as an example for all our partner agencies to show them that playing together is a heck of a lot better than playing alone. You feel a need, you fill a void that's been here for a long time. I'm very, very proud that you chose to partner with us, and we are immensely happy that you're here. Thank you so much, Tony, for getting this ball rolling. And again, when Jeanette and Barb says that you guys rock, you really do. Thank you so much.
Betsy Price, a Fort Worth native, was elected in 2011 as the 44th mayor of the city of Fort Worth. She was re-elected in 2015 to a third two-year term. Along with her focus on promoting jobs, strengthening education, fighting crime, and improving mobility, Mayor Price has made significant strides along the path toward her vision of a healthy, engaged, and fiscally responsible city. Please welcome Mayor Betsy Price.
Good morning.
Good morning.
You know, we get to do so much as a city, but to get to come out and see our actual neighbors involved in making their neighborhood better, serving those who really need it, is just one of the best parts of what I do during the day. So thank you all for caring. Tony, thank you for sparking that light. It often takes just one person who has a passion to get the neighborhoods engaged and started. And indeed, I believe you've done that. And now we expect you to replicate in Parker County that passion. But don't forget about Fort Worth, because Fort Worth truly is a compassionate city. It's a city that cares about those who need our help and step up. 2 weeks ago, we wrapped up the Mayor's Week of Compassion, and many of you may have been involved. My faith-based cabinet drives that, and they did about 5,000 hours worth of service for the community, returning back to people in areas particularly where it was needed, from litter pickup to serving the hungry to reading to children, just a wide variety of issues. But the 4Saints Episcopal Food Pantry is much needed as we work towards our goal of a healthy, engaged, vibrant community. If you have huge holes in the ability to deliver food to families, to children, it's very cyclical. It goes back to education. Children who are hungry don't learn well. they're not well nourished. Even if they're not just hungry, they're not eating the foods they need. Those food deserts must be addressed, and our Blue Zones project is working hard on helping us with that goal, and you are a big piece of that. Bo Soderberg knows the stats that I'm going to give you, but 1 in 6 people of all ages struggle with food insecurity. And 1 in 4 children come from families where food is a daily, if not a weekly, issue for them. That's a staggering, in a nation of plenty, that's a staggering statistic. But what you're doing here in the Meadowbrook community really does go a long way towards helping that. Our officers who are back here know that if children are fed and families are fed, if neighbors are out watching their community, helping those in need, their job becomes a little bit easier. Thank you guys for serving this community too. But the really cool thing here is the number of volunteers we have giving back. And I'll have to tell you, I'm especially impressed with Annabelle. Annabelle is 13 years old. Now, what does that say about the city and our future? I think it says wonderful things that she's already serving as a board member. You need to get the rest of your scout troop engaged. We start them young and we grow them up, and this city that we love will continue to help those in need. So thank you each and every one for your prayers, for your faithfulness for the city, and especially for donating your precious time and your precious resources to serve those who need your help. It makes Fort Worth an incredible city to live in and to serve. Thank you.
Now to introduce another mayor, the Right Reverend J. Scott Mayor. The other mayor. Bishop Mayor was elected the 4th Provisional Bishop of the Episcopal Diocese of Fort Worth on May 16th of 2015. He is a native and lifelong Texan, born in Dallas, raised in Lubbock and Fort Worth. Bishop Mayor has a long and deep connection to this city. He and his younger brothers were baptized and confirmed at St. Andrew's Episcopal Church. They attended Fort Worth Public Schools and graduated from Southwest High School. He enjoyed summers playing baseball at University Little League. Several of Bishop Mayer's family members continue to reside in the Fort Worth area. Please welcome Bishop Scott Mayer.
Another mayor, two mayors over there. Great privilege to bless this amazing ministry. If everyone would open your pamphlets, the opportunities to participate, you may need to share. Come together today to seek God's blessing as we set apart this space, the new ministry which it will house, the people who will labor in that ministry, and those who will benefit from this ministry. This is the day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord, you have taught us that without love, whatever we do is worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts your greatest gift, which is love, the true bond of peace and of all virtue, without which whoever lives is accounted dead before you. Grant this for the sake of your only Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Deacon Annette.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you? The king will reply, truly I tell you, whatever you did for the least one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me.
The litany for the mission of the food pantry. Oh God, we pray for the gifts of ministry. Inspire our minds with a vision of your kingdom in this time and place.
Hear us, O Lord.
Touch our eyes, that we may see your glory in all creation.
Hear us, O Lord.
Touch our ears, that we may hear from every mouth the hunger for hope and stories of refreshment.
Hear us, O Lord.
Touch our lips, that we may tell in every tongue and dialect the wonderful works of God.
Hear us, O Lord.
Touch our hearts, that we may discern the mission to which you call us.
Hear us, O Lord.
Touch our feet, that we may take your good news into our neighborhoods, communities, and all parts of the world.
Hear us, O Lord.
Touch our hands, that we may accomplish the work you give us to do.
Hear us, O Lord.
Blessed are you, O Lord, ruler of the universe. You fill the entire world with your presence and command us to tell the world of your love. Accept and bless this space and those who minister in it and those who are served by 4Saints Episcopal Food Pantry. May the four congregations who created this new ministry be bound with a holy commitment of service in your world. May those who labor here be filled with the joy of your presence. May those who contribute to the work here be filled with your courage and strength. May those who are served here be touched by your unfailing love. May the community which surrounds it receive abundant blessings through the ministry which is provided here. And always remind us that as we too are broken, poured, and shared for the world's feeding, we find ourselves made whole in you. Oh God the Father, bless this space and the new work that we undertake, that your name may be glorified now and forever. God the Son, bless those who plant and tend this new ministry, that they may create a place of welcome and a life-giving spring. God the Holy Spirit, bless those who will be served here, that they may be encouraged and supported by your unfailing love.
Amen.
And now we will make this grand opening of this blessed space complete with an official ribbon cutting.